steps be guided by your promise, may evil never rule me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
With your spirit. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that schooled through Lenten observance and nourished by your word, through holy restraint, we may be devoted to you with all our heart and be ever united in prayer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people and said, "Now, Israel, hear the statutes and decrees which I am teaching you to observe, that you may live and may enter in and take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, is giving you. Therefore, I teach you the statutes and decrees as the Lord, my God, has commanded me, that you may observe them in the land you are entering to occupy. Observe them carefully, for thus will you give evidence of your wisdom and intelligence to the nations. Who will hear of all these statutes and say, 'This great nation is truly a wise and intelligent people'? For what great nation is there that has God so close to it as the Lord our God is to us whenever we call upon him? Or what great nation has statutes and decrees that are as just as the whole law, which I am setting before you today? However, take care and be earnestly on your guard, not to forget the things which your own eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your memory as long as you live. But teach them to your children and to your children's children, the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you.
Praise the Lord.
He sends forth his command.
say to you, until heaven and earth pass away, not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do so will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When Jesus speaks of the law and the prophets, he of course speaks to the whole and the integrity of Jewish tradition, which includes not just customs and laws and traditions, but the whole story. And we hear in the first reading how Moses passes on this goodness to those who come after. We too have this sacred charge. We must pass on what we have received, because the story of Judeo-Christianity is not just a story. It's so much more. It's who we are. It's more than a story of a chosen people. It's the story of God and his chosen people and the relationship and their growth and how they have risen from lowliness, from abandoning God, to not choosing him, to worshiping false idols, all the way up to, through all of the covenants, to the time of Jesus Christ, when that covenant is finally and ultimately fulfilled, which was the goal of the previous covenants, all of which failed through the fault of the people. And so to forsake or ignore or not pay heed to that story is to ignore all the good work that has already happened, all the good that brought us to this point. Sure, we did not live in the time before Jesus. You might argue that's not my story, but I would say that is your story. That's your story and that's my story, because the Israelites throughout time, up until the time of Jesus, their experiences were not just unique to them. We share a lot of those experiences. We share those struggles. It's the story of the human experience. And woe to anyone who thinks that they would be more advanced than perhaps the Israelites following Moses, or perhaps the people in the time of Noah. All of them go through these human experiences as well, and God accompanies them through these struggles. Yes, time and again they do fail. They don't uphold their end of the covenant, and God has to save them once again. But this story is part of how we understand who we are today, even though we may not be centuries old to have lived through it. We share a bit of that experience as well. And we have the benefit of living on the other side of the peak of the timeline, which was the incarnation, and especially the crucifixion and sacrifice of Jesus, which attained for us our salvation. We have access to the fulfillment of the prophets and the fulfillment of the law. And this is of great benefit to us. Remember that Jesus and his teachings, though new in a way, were not a break from the old. Jesus' teachings are simultaneously simple and yet the most advanced in them, the highest tier that they can be. The first thing that comes to mind, one of the central tenets of what Jesus preached, was quite simply the tenet of love above all else. Love takes precedence over adhering to the letter of the law. When Jesus speaks about loving your neighbor and even to the point of loving your enemy, Jesus is getting back to the heart of why the law was given in the first place. Look at the law in the time of Moses. He brought them the commandments. The commandments was essentially a point where God said, look, my people, you have forgotten how to love, and your hearts have become so stony, so I have to start to spell it out for you. We're going to take baby steps to get back to having a good and holy heart, a heart of flesh, not a heart of stone. And so these are some of the basics. You will not kill, you will not steal, you will not have other gods before me. You will keep holding the Sabbath. This is what someone who has a good heart will do. Jesus returns to that by prompting us to love. I've mentioned many times how evil creeps into our life and distorts and twists our understandings so that the good intentions that we might have had kind of become nullified. This is exactly what happened with Jewish adherence to the law. They adhered to the letter of the law, children, to your friends, to your relatives. We need to know that timeline because that experience is our experience too. And it's the story of how God came to this good relationship with his people, how it evolved over time, how it came to the point where we have it today. Moses knew the importance of sharing this story with those around us. And one awkward part about Moses' ministry, if you will, it's hard to speak about ministry in a time of strictly Judaism because in Judaism there is no evangelization. You're either born a Jew or you're not. You're either part of the fold or you're not. There's really not much room for conversation. Sure, outsiders can marry into the fold, but this is not quite evangelization like we would know it. With the coming of Jesus, the family was opened up. We establish our family and membership not by blood anymore, but by faith. And thank goodness for that. I don't know if I have a lick of Jewish blood in me. I wouldn't want to be cut off from the chosen people of God. But thanks be to Christ that we now have access to this, that we are a part of the fold, that through our faith we consider ourselves members of that chosen family. What a privilege for us, and what a duty for us to study our family history, to know it, to master it. Think about couples who are deeply in love with one another. Perhaps a married couple in their 80s or 90s. Think how lovingly they can recall the stories of their youth, the time that they spent together. How the recalling of those stories fosters the love that they have for one another. We have a story too. Like that couple, like that sweet old couple sitting together, rocking sweet, recalling stories of the past, we must recall these stories. We must recall these to enhance our love, our relationship with God, to foster the love that he has for us and our love for him. And as we foster that relationship, many good fruits will come from that as well. So I encourage you, I know the Bible can be intimidating, but please crack it open and look through the Old Testament, through the New. Look at these stories of how we got to where we are now. Cherish these stories in your hearts. Think back to your days of catechism. Hopefully you had a good experience of catechism. Hopefully there was a lot of fruit that came from that. Engage these and share them with those around us, both to help bring others into the fold, to bring them into the family by faith, and also to continue to enhance your current relationship with God. Reflect on these days of old with happiness in your heart and with a grateful heart. A lot of work has happened to bring us to where we are today. It's a beautiful story with many struggles and triumphs. It's also our story, so we would do well to study it. Faith and confidence that our Heavenly Father hears our needs, let us turn to him and present these petitions.
The church leaders may shepherd the baptized in fulfilling the law of love. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Jewish people may remain faithful to the call of the first covenant, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations and their leaders may discern the ways of righteousness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That judges and police may temper justice with mercy, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be willing students of
bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for the forgiveness we have received, the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all the holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the prayers of your people along with these sacrificial offerings, and defend those who celebrate your mysteries from every kind of danger, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through bodily fasting you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, and bestow both virtue and its rewards through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Salvator, Venis sunt Celi et Terra, Gloria Tua.
Down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of truth. together with Francis our Pope and David our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you.
Please pray with us now, the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
May the heavenly banquet at which we have been fed sanctify us, O Lord, and cleanse us of all errors. Make us worthy of your promises from on high, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. Give to your people, O God, a resolve that is pleasing to you. For by conforming them to your teachings, you bestow on them every favor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.